Hello and welcome to Couch 44 on Channel 44. My name is Laura Franklin and today I'm joined by the lovely Saara Lamberg, who is a Finnish-Australian filmmaker, writer, director, actor, producer. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, so excited to be here.
Now, Saara, you've had quite the extraordinary career. Where did it all begin for you?
I suppose it began as a seven-year-old little actor back in Finland.
Yeah.
So my mother used to be acting sort of semi-professionally, and she took me along to rehearsals, and I was seven, so I was full of energy, so yeah. I was a little brat, very annoying, running around the place. So the director decided to put me in the play just to get rid of some of that energy, I guess, yeah. And it was Shakespeare of all things, and seven-year-old me did not understand a word of it, because it's Shakespeare, it's very adult language, but I just remembered everyone's lines, so I became really useful as a prompter.
Yeah.
I don't know if I was any good as an actor back then, but I was certainly useful for when people forgot their lines. So that was very first introduction, I guess, to acting, and it grew from there, and
yep.
I went on to being in various youth groups as an actor, and did some film work back then, mm-hmm. just short films.
As a teenager?
Yeah, or? So from seven to, yep. you know, forever, up until now, I've always acted in one yep. way or another. First mainly stage work, and then more and more film.
Yeah.
And then went on to study radio and television production back mm-hmm. in Finland.
Wow.
And so learned, you know, the behind the scenes work, how to work with audio and camera and all of those things, yep. and producing. And then went back to acting, studied an acting degree in England, and then came to Australia where I started producing work and produced five short films mm-hmm. before I went on to making my first feature, Innuendo.
Wow, that's extraordinary. Would you say that all the travel, and I read somewhere that you even stopped, was it India, and did a yoga course in between traveling. Would you say that all that travel and experiences in those different countries, like to live in them and study in them and work in them, has inspired, I guess, some of the works that you've produced?
Oh, definitely, yeah. I think it's just helped me understand people better, mm-hmm. seeing people from different cultures, living in very, very different environments. Like, mm-hmm. I think it's just important, not just for a filmmaker, but for any human,
yeah.
to understand other humans.
Yeah.
And definitely for anyone who wants to tell stories, I think it's very important to have that kind of universal understanding of how human beings operate,
yeah.
and how similar and different we are at the same time. Yeah, I think it's definitely made me a better filmmaker, hopefully a better human.
And when you came to Australia, what was, well, I guess, one of the first works that you began working on when you got here? Did you begin with writing, or did you start with acting? When you came to Australia, how did you get involved with the filmmaking scene?
Yeah, so when I first entered the country, I became an artist in residence at okay. Montsalvat. Artist Colony, which is in Melbourne.
Mm-hmm.
So I lived there for the first year, pretty much, of being in Australia, and that was just, it's a beautiful, it's the oldest artist colony in Australia, and it's a beautiful setting in itself to be creating art, plus you meet lots of wonderful people.
Yeah.
So those were some of my first introductions to Australian artists, and I went on to work with Melbourne Theatre Company called Eagle's Nest Theatre.
Okay.
And as an actor, was involved in a play called Cosi by Louis Nora.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, that was probably the first Australian production that I did, apart from my own artist in residency productions that I was filming in Montsalvat.
Yeah. What was it like being on, I guess, stage with Australian artists, and did you meet anyone in particular that really inspired you or that you continue to work with at all? Or?
Oh yeah, absolutely. I think I bring people with me from all projects yeah. that I work on. My favourite people, they follow me or I follow them, and,
yeah.
and I mean it's like this family that I create around myself, because original families on the other side of the world, and It's just important for me to have a friend family mm-hmm. around me. So yeah, I surround myself with people from different projects. And yeah, there's still a couple of people that I work with from that very first production. Kevin D in particular, who's been on a couple of films that I've directed since. Mm-hmm. And yeah, a couple of other people too.
So going back to your work, what would you say is your proudest film that you have written and directed?
Hopefully the next one.
Ooh, yeah, I've seen that you've got one coming out and one still in post-production.
I guess what I mean by that is that I always want to be just making better work than I did before. And I would hope to be developing as an artist. And but in some ways, I guess the first one is always... My first feature was a big undertaking because I had no idea what I was doing. Having made short films before, of course, I sort of knew what I was doing, but feature is just such a different... It's a different ball game. Yeah. And so many things that I just learned as I was doing it. Mm-hmm. And it's been received enormously well. Like, it went to avenues that I never imagined it would go to. It's been on national television. It's mm-hmm. been on a lot of film festivals. We had cinema release for it. That was one of my dreams, to have a cinema release. So that was awesome that that happened. And the kind of feedback that I've got from that film is also just... It's humbling, and it kind of shows me that it was worth doing and all that heartache was worth it. So in some ways, innuendo is always going to be very important.
Yeah. So your film Innuendo, how many film festivals and awards did that win on its festival run?
Yeah, it's been on at least, I think, 10 festivals. We won the Cinema Australia Award. Audience Award for it, and Fine Arts Film Festival in Los Angeles, we won the best film, and also in Milan, we won the best film.
Wow, that's awesome.
Thank you.
Did you get to go to any of those festivals? Were you there for any of them?
I certainly did, and I decided, because Innuendo got into quite a few festivals around the world, interesting places like America, a few places in Europe, New Caledonia. So I decided to film my next feature as I was on that journey.
Yeah.
So it's called The Lies We Tell Ourselves. Yeah. And it's a comedy mockumentary about a filmmaker that travels to film festivals screening her film.
Yeah. I love that.
I wonder who played the part.
Did you have someone follow you around with a camera, or was it like all kind of selfie vlogging style?
Yeah, unfortunately there wasn't really enough of a budget to take anyone with me, so it was pretty much me engaging people from the locations where I was, helping as cast and or crew, but sometimes it was just me operating everything. We also went to Cannes Film Festival, where I was very lucky to show Innuendo, and quite a few people went with me there. Yep. So we did lots of filming there. That was quite exciting.
Yeah, that would have been very exciting. Well, I guess if you had any last advice just to give to any filmmakers out there or people looking into the arts world, what do you suggest is their first steps?
I think what really helped me was going to lots of industry events, mm-hmm. going to film festivals, going to talk events, listening to experts talk about their craft, and then constantly pushing myself out of my comfort zone. So when I went to those events, not only did I listen to them talking, but then afterwards I went and introduced myself, mm-hmm. asked, is it okay to send you an email? Is it okay to call you? Can we have a coffee? Just getting to know people and just getting as much information from all sorts of sources. Mm-hmm. And I certainly have experienced that when I went in with that open mind and friendly attitude, people were very willing to help me. Yeah. And no one's got a lot of time, but they usually have a little bit of time. And I guess as a newcomer, just being very flexible with your own time. like if you ask for someone for a meeting, you take whatever they offer you.
Yeah, yeah.
You don't go, no, I can't make that because I've got my sister's birthday. No, you go. You tell your sister you're going to the birthday later. It's like as a, I guess being humble as a newcomer, but also inquisitive.
Yeah.
Asking for help, accepting any help that you can get. Going to events, volunteering as much as possible.
Yeah.
Doing as many projects as you can, and again, whatever job on that film set or on that project that you're doing, it doesn't need to be exactly the thing that you want to be doing. It can be anything, just to be in that environment, experiencing it, learning from everyone.
Mm-hmm.
Just being open with people, making connections. I think being in film is constantly making connections.
Yeah.
And yeah, I think that's a few things there. I'm sure there's a lot more.
Yeah, there've been so many things, but I think that's wonderful, great first steps is making those connections and getting yourself out there. Well, thank you so much for coming on Couch 44. It's been lovely to have you and to hear all your adventures and journey as a filmmaker. That is a wrap for us today. Thank you for tuning in on Couch 44. My name is Laura Franklin. We hope to see you next time.